The regular HID Remapper is an adapter for USB input devices. You plug it into a USB port on your computer, and you plug USB devices into it. It doesn't change the basic protocol, it's still USB, but it allows you to modify the signal in various ways, like reassign button functions on a mouse, or make a keyboard work as a game controller. What is the Bluetooth version of HID Remapper then? A few possibilities come to mind. Maybe it's a Bluetooth to Bluetooth adapter that receives inputs from Bluetooth devices and sends inputs to your computer over Bluetooth as well. Maybe it's a USB to Bluetooth adapter that you can plug USB devices into and it connects to your computer over Bluetooth. Or maybe it's the other way around. You connect it to your computer over USB, but it talks to Bluetooth mice, keyboards, etc. Currently, the only version that exists is the last one. It's a Bluetooth to USB adapter. You connect input devices to it over Bluetooth, and you plug it into your computer over USB. And it can do most of the things the regular USB to USB HID Remapper does. Let me show you. When it comes to hardware, there are currently two boards that you can use for the Bluetooth version of HID Remapper. One is the Adafruit Feather NRF52840 Express. It looks like this. Here's the product page. The other is Seed Studio Xiao NRF52840. It looks like this. And here is its product page. For development, the Adafruit board is better, because it has a debug port. But if you just want to use it, they pretty much work the same. So just get whichever one is available to you or cheaper. The Xiao board works great, the only thing it's missing, in comparison, is a button, and it's not a big deal. Let's see what it looks like in practice. I'll connect the Xiao board to my computer over USB. And I'll try to connect this Bluetooth mouse to it. If you've used Bluetooth devices before, you know that they typically need to be paired first. You put the mouse, or whatever device it is, in pairing mode, then you search for it from your computer. With HID Remapper, it's similar. We need to put HID Remapper in pairing mode, and we need to put the mouse in pairing mode. On the Adafruit board, we can do it using this button. But the Xiao board doesn't have a button, so we do it from HID Remapper's configuration interface. It's the same website that you use with the regular USB version of HID Remapper. If you connect to a Bluetooth HID Remapper, then in the Actions tab, there is an additional button, Pair New Device. Actually, if it's the first device that we are connecting to our Bluetooth HID Remapper, we don't even need to do that. If it's not paired with any device, then it will search for new devices by default. In any case, the solid blue light here means that it is now in pairing mode. Now we just need to put our mouse in pairing mode, and this is typically done by holding some button. In our case, it's this button here. Okay, I think they're now connected. Depending on your device, this part might look different. Some devices have multiple slots you can cycle through, so that you can connect them to multiple computers. So just do whatever you would normally do if you were connecting your mouse or keyboard to your computer or mobile device. Okay, let's see if it works. The cursor is moving, so we can see that it works. Let's go to the Monitor tab to see the inputs. Now we can do anything we normally could with the USB version of HID Remapper. For example, let's swap the left and right mouse buttons. I'll make one mapping that maps the left button to the right button, and another that maps the right button to the left button. Save the configuration to our HID remapper. And now the buttons are swapped. If this was all you wanted to do, you probably wouldn't need HID remapper, but it was just an example. You could, of course, create more complex configurations, maybe connect multiple devices at the same time. An important thing to note here is that currently HID remapper only works with Bluetooth low energy devices. There are two main types of Bluetooth, the original one, which we now call Bluetooth Classic, and the new one, which is called Bluetooth Low Energy or LE. They share the branding, but they have almost nothing in common otherwise. Most computers, phones, tablets, etc. support both types, and you don't even have to think about it. But any given mouse, keyboard or gamepad will almost certainly only work with either Bluetooth Classic or Bluetooth LE, and not both. If you're not sure whether your mouse or keyboard uses Bluetooth Classic or Bluetooth LE, you can install this app called NRF Connect on your phone or tablet, then put your mouse or keyboard in pairing mode and see if it shows up in the scanner inside the NRF Connect app. If it does, it means it's using Bluetooth LE, and you should be able to use it with the Bluetooth version of HID Remapper. Finally, please keep in mind that while the Bluetooth version works, as we have seen, it should be treated as an experimental thing. It's not as widely used and tested as the USB version. So you might encounter some issues simply because you're the first one to use a certain device with it. That said, I think it's worth a try. If you have any questions, please leave a comment. For more information about HID Remapper, see the project's GitHub repository. And thanks for watching.